This is actually a splitty figure. So what's up, fellow collectors? So my name is Mr. Pogi and I am here to review this awesome, well, actually this is an old toy from Toy Biz. This is the classic, not the classic Spider-Man, but this is the Tobey Maguire Spider-Man way back in 2002. So this is the superposable Spider-Man figure from 2002 with the gargoyle statue right here. Now, just a brief biography of Spider-Man. So his name is Peter Parker, Peter Benjamin Parker. Now he got bitten by a radioactive spider, and then when he was bitten, he became this awesome Spider-Man. And for Spider-Man, his powers are, well, you know, wall-crawling abilities, and he can lift about 1 or 2 tons. So I'm not sure with that. And also, for the spider web, it doesn't come out organically. So he created the serum for the spider web fluid. And then also for this version of Spider-Man, for the Spider-Man movie that went out way back in 2002, I think. So this one was a new Spider-Man because he has an organic webbing. Okay, so the webs comes out in his wrist. So he's like an actual spider with that. And enough about that, let's dig in with our Spider-Man from 2002. This version of Spider-Man is was based from the movie Spider-Man, the one with Tobey Maguire. Is so with the issue of the Sony and Disney dispute and problems with the financing, so here's a review. Let's go to the classic Spider-Man. So actually, I got really inspired with this Spider-Man when I was a kid, and that is why I took up mass communication, because with Spider-Man, he is a photographer from Daily Bugle. Now for the details of this figure, this is a really good figure. According to the box, it has 30 points of articulation, and you can see the logo of Spider-Man. So it's a bit, well, I'm just gonna zoom it. It's a bit worn out already because this was way back in 2002 pa. Well, the details of his suit, it's actually pretty amazing right there. And then for the legs there, I actually put something sticky in it when I was a kid way back in 2002 there. And then also for the other feet there. And then as you can see for his details again, his thighs are a little big, and then his waist is a little bit small, but actually this is a really good figure. So this is one of my holy grail for me because I like this one. I've been keeping this since I was a kid, and I was surprised that it is still in my I think it was in my cabinet there. Some of his paint apps are already fading due to old age there. Look at this one. This is where his web fluid comes out. So there. Okay, now let's go with the articulation. For the articulation, you can move his head 360. For his head, you can move his head way up there, and you can make him look down. Not really make him look down, but for the leg, for the neck, he has this rotation for the neck. It's a it's different from the rotation of his head. So you can rotate his head as well as his neck. And then for the shoulders, it's kind of limited. Okay, so it's limited for the, so you can rotate the shoulders, but you cannot move it way up there. And then for the bicep swivel, and then double jointed elbows, as well as for the forearms, you can rotate his forearms. His wrist, you can do this, and then there's a swivel in the wrist, and then the common Spidey sign where he used this. Well, actually, just a quick trivia, he does it like this. He must use a lot of force when he does, because it will depend with his pinch like this in his wrist for his web fluid to come out. Because if he pinch a little soft, the web fluid will come out a little, no force with it, okay? So he needs to exert the force. And for the, well, this is for his, what do you call this one? His hips, no, this is the hips. His torso, so you can, actually, you cannot rotate this one, okay? And then also for his hips, there, you can turn it around. And then for the legs, you cannot move his legs like this, but you can move his legs like that, with that, and then you can make him split. Okay, so this is actually a splitty figure. And then the rotation of the thighs, double jointed knees, and then you can rotate his calves and ankle pivot, there is, and then a toe there, where I've been looking for the Hasbro to create something like this so that you can pose a figure that can bend his toes, but Hasbro doesn't have that one. I don't know if it's necessary or not, but I miss that one. You can pose this figure like this. That's why I pose the figures when I intro this one. There, you can do the classic Spider-Man pose. Now for this accessory, actually it's incomplete, but here is his gargoyle statue. So you can pull this one. I think I've broken it already, but you can pull it one, and then it pulls itself with this mechanical figure or button. Now for the details of this statue, it's actually pretty good. You can display it at the end of your shelf or your cabinet and so on, and make Spider-Man hanging from it. And I put something sticky in this one so that I can put it in the wall. That's the gargoyle statue. So I'll just zoom it in so you can see. It's actually pretty good, right? There. Now for this figure, do I recommend it? Well, if you are a Spider-Man fan, I actually recommend this one. But with the new Spider-Mans that comes out almost every month, every year lately, especially with the Tom Holland figure, it's okay not to get this one. But if you like it, well, you can get it because you like it, right? So that's it. So thank you for viewing my YouTube channel. So please, if you have time, please like, comment, share, and subscribe. And also, I just want to greet the toy group that I am in. It's Toy Concord Philippines. So hello, guys. Hello. So Spider-Man says hello, even though with the issue right now. Okay. And then also, click the notification bell if you have my time. But if you don't, well, I'm not forcing you to make you subscribe. Okay, so just please share this video if you like. Okay, so now thank you, and I hope you have a great day. Okay. Goodbye, guys.